Hi, my name's Lisa Sadleir. I'm a relocation consultant and a personal property finder.
Hi, my name is Javier Ismáel Fernandez, and I am a real estate and immigration lawyer in Costa del Sol.
Today we're going to introduce you to two of the most popular visas for non-Europeans wanting to move to Spain.
The Golden Visa and the Non-Lucrative Visa.
The Golden Visa is almost like a passport to Europe for you and your family. Although it's new to British passport holders following Brexit, we've been working with the Golden Visa for Americans and Canadians and other non-Europeans over the past years. The non-lucrative visa is basically the easiest option maybe for retirees and anyone wanting to test the water before making a larger financial commitment to this country.
Remember, after watching our video, you can send us your questions that we will answer in an FAQ video.
And we also have a Facebook page, Spain Visa. We will add a link to the bottom of this video for you to join us and join in the conversation. Okay, Javier, let's start with the Golden Visa. What is the Golden Visa and who is it for?
The Golden Visa is a residency permit for non-European citizens who make a capital investment in Spain. Being the most popular option, the purchase of a real estate property to the value of 500,000 euros or more.
Okay, so it's the purchase of property in Spain for at least 500,000 euros. And in a nutshell, what's the application process?
Well, the first step of the process is the purchase of the property. After this, we have to proceed with the registration of the property in the name of the buyer in the land registry, and then we are ready to start the Golden Visa process. We have two options. Option number one, if the applicant is in Spain at the time of submitting the application, the authority that will be dealing with the process will be the Central Immigration Department in Madrid.
Okay.
On the other side, if the applicant is not in Spain, we will start the process with the Spanish consulate in the home country.
Okay, so basically the first step is to purchase the property, which most people do by being here, or obviously we can offer a remote property purchase service. And then for the paperwork side of the visa, that's something that you can deal with the purchase actually here in Spain or in their home country, is that correct?
Exactly, correct.
Perfect, okay. And what would you say were the main requirements for the Golden Visa?
Well, the main requirement is the acquisition of a real estate property to the value of 500,000 euros or more. When we talk about the investment, we're talking about one or several properties. But the most important thing, what we have to point out is that the investment should be free of charges, so only mortgages on the excess will be allowed.
Okay, so basically what you're saying is you could buy a property, say, for 800,000 euros, but for 500,000 of which must be free of a mortgage, so basically purchased in cash, and then they can take a mortgage for any amount over the 500,000, is that correct?
Yes, 500,000 euros should be on plans of the investor.
Perfect, because actually what's been a popular option for British families now moving to Spain is to purchase a family home for around about, say, 350,000-400,000, and then to purchase a second property, say, for 150,000, like an apartment as a rental investment, as a rental income, and that's totally acceptable, provided the amount's over 500,000 and there are no mortgages involved.
Yes, exactly.
Perfect, okay. Right, that's the financing clear. What would you say are the other main requirements for a successful Golden Visa application?
Well, the main requirements are private health insurance, not having criminal records, and the proof of having sufficient means, yes, to support yourself financially and your family during the time of the residency in Spain.
Okay, but when I've helped somebody purchase the property, and then it comes to processing all the paperwork for the Golden Visa, you take care of all that for them, don't
you? Yeah, definitely.
Okay, and just to finish on the Golden Visa, what would you say are the main advantages of the Spanish Golden Visa?
Well, in my opinion, the main advantage is the possibility to get a permit that you can't renew by simply maintaining the investment and entering into Spain once a year. Okay. Secondly, because the renewal does not entail the tax residency in Spain, which gives the investor the option to decide whether to stay in Spain with the family permanently or not. And finally, because it comes with a work permit. Yeah?
Okay.
So you can work in Spain, and of course you can travel freely within the Schengen area.
Okay, so just to make sure I fully understood that, basically The first work permits for the first golden visa allows residency for 2 years, and there isn't a required minimum amount of time that you have to stay in Spain. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. Yeah, the important thing to understand is that the advantage of applying, being the applicant in Spain, is that you go straight to the 2 years residency permit.
Okay, and unlike the non-lucrative, which we're going to talk about in a moment, it doesn't require you to become a tax resident in Spain. It gives you that freedom.
That's it.
Perfect, thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, now we'll look at the non-lucrative visa. Javier, what is the non-lucrative visa and who is it designed for?
The non-lucrative visa allows the non-European citizens to stay in Spain for more than 90 days without carrying out work or professional activity.
So that basically means not working in Spain at all?
Exactly.
Okay, it was originally designed and referred to as the retirement visa, wasn't it? Designed for people that already have savings and have a pensionable income. Okay, in a nutshell, what's the application process?
When we talk about the application process, it's important to understand that we have to apply for before moving to Spain.
Okay.
It is also important to point out that the visa is valid only for 90 days. So you have to consider the timing, the right timing. And also that once you enter Spain, you have 30 days to go to the police station, put the fingerprint and apply for the residency card.
Okay, so basically the non-lucrative visa must be applied for in your consulate in the UK, whether it be London, Manchester or Scotland. Once you have the visa, it is valid for 90 days, in which time you must move to Spain. And once in Spain, you have 1 month to go to the local police station to apply for your TIE residency card.
That's
correct.
The process, exactly, Liz.
Perfect. And the main requirements for a non-lucrative visa?
The main requirement is to have financial means to support yourself and your family during the time of the residency in Spain, mm-hmm. basically.
Okay. Those quantities change every year based on a figure provided.
Exactly, the authorities, they publish every year the amounts. But okay. we can talk about this in another video.
Exactly, there's lots of information on the website non-lucrativevisaspain.com. We'll put the link in the comments later and you can read more about that, and we will answer any questions in a further video. Like the golden visa, you also need to have healthcare.
Yeah, basically the requirements are quite similar. So we're talking about private health insurance. We're talking about not having criminal records and also providing some other personal documents.
Perfect. And I think the most important thing to point out, as you mentioned before, Javier, about the non-lucrative visa, is the time sensitivity of so many documents. You've got to get so many original documents, get them legalized, get them sworn translated. Every single page costs about £40 to £50, we've been quoting, so it's not a cheap option. It's really, really important to get the timing right, isn't it?
It all costs money, so you have to make sure that you're going to be successful with the application, because the money will not be refunded.
Okay, so basically, what would you say were the advantages of the non-lucrative over the golden visa, for example?
Well, it all comes down to finances.
Yeah. Sure.
If you have no economic capacity to invest 500,000 euros, that could be a good option for you.
Perfect, thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, so we've covered the non-lucrative visa and the golden visa, who they're designed for, the main requirements and the application processes. Now, Javier, if it's all right, I'd like to ask you some specific questions about these visas and for different situations. My first question is, if someone was in a position to apply for either of those visas, which one would you recommend and why?
I would definitely recommend the golden visa because of the tax advantages, the possibility to get a work permit, the one to decide whether you want to stay here permanently or not.
Mm-hmm.
And also because if you apply when you're in Spain, you get the residency permit for 2 years.
Okay. And the ability to work as well, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
This visa. Yeah. Perfect. Okay. Now, this one might be a bit more controversial. As you know, as a relocation consultant, I'm regularly recommending people to rent a property before they buy. What would you say if I was to recommend a family moving over, for example, to take the non-lucrative visa initially with view to converting to the golden visa in the first 12 months?
What's your reason for this, Lisa?
Basically, unless you really, really know an area, you spent a lot of time there, you're not always 100% certain you're in the right place initially. So to invest €500,000 in a property and then find out it's not your ideal area, the children aren't in the ideal school, I believe that's a risk. So I feel like if the family moves over with the 12-month non-lucrative visa, they're certain then after 6 months or so that they're in the right place, they're in the right location, they're happy with the school, and then they can start their property search with view to converting to the Golden Visa before the end of the year. Would that be possible?
Yeah, I agree with you, Lisa. The non-lucrative visa is valid for 1 year, which means that if the investor, proceeds with a purchase of a property of 500,000 meters in the first year, we can change, we can convert the non-lucrative visa into a Golden Visa. Yes,
perfect.
Definitely.
Perfect. So it basically, especially when you're moving with children, it gives them the family a peace of mind, yeah, that they're making the right decision. And I know this is, a bit more complicated. As the non-lucrative visa does not allow you to work at all in Spain, now with Britain being outside of the EU, what are the options for working in Spain?
Well, we have a couple of options. We can talk about the Golden Visa for business projects, and we can also talk about the self-employed or entrepreneur visa. But the main problem is that we are talking about permits that they are based on non-objective requirements. Yeah.
Right.
So I find them initially risky, and I think it's quite the possibilities of being successful are low initially.
Okay, so basically, if you're thinking of setting up a company in Spain and wanting to go for the self-employed visa, contact Javier direct. We'll put his contact details at the end of this video. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, that's all for today then. I think we've covered lots of points, lots of information. Hopefully we've answered some of your questions. It is a lot of information to take in, so we will add links to articles, how to contact us in the comments below, and we will welcome you to join our Facebook group, Spain Visa, where we have an active conversation going where we provide accurate answers to your questions. And we'll add all that in the comments below.
And please remember to subscribe to our channel and to send us your questions. We will be happy to answer them in an FAQ video.
And again, thanks for joining us today. We'll be back with you shortly, and we look forward to welcoming you to Southern Spain.
Thank you.